Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the graduating class of Parker University.
All right, thank you. Well, good morning and welcome, everyone. I am Dr. Patrick Bodner. I'm the Chief Compliance Officer at Parker University, and I'm honored to celebrate commencement with you today. To begin our ceremony, please join me in standing for the invocation, and then please remain standing for the singing of the national anthem by a Parker University DC alumnus, Dr. Nicholas Haney. So please stand and let's bow our heads in prayer. Almighty God, today our hearts are filled with gratitude as we honor and celebrate Parker University graduates. Thank you for guiding us to this wondrous commencement day. Thank you for our graduates, family and friends, teachers and mentors who have helped get them to this moment and see that great things are in the reach of those who serve others. We hope their happiness be at least as great as ours on this occasion. Bless all the faculty, administration, and staff at Parker University who have educated our graduates intellectually, spiritually, and physically. We pray that our graduates live in the promise of your word and will and step out into the world in faith, because they were created on purpose, for a purpose, and with plans to prosper. In your name we pray. Amen. Okay, please remain standing and welcome to the stage for the singing of the national anthem, Dr. Nicholas Hanney.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, oh, the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Thank you, Dr. Hanney. That was wonderful. So please take your seats, and to get things started, please join me in welcoming Parker University's Executive Vice President and Provost, Dr. Jane Mischella.
Thank you, Dr. Bodner. As the Executive Vice President and Provost of Parker University, it is my distinct pleasure to welcome everyone here today. Graduates, commencement marks a significant milestone in your lives. This ceremony is more than just one day in a student's life. It's about honoring the years of hard work and dedication to get to this point. In the past few years, our students have encountered numerous challenges, and we deeply admire and honor their unwavering perseverance in overcoming these obstacles. At Parker University, we feel it is also essential to recognize a group of dedicated individuals who have given much time and effort to assist these graduates in achieving their goals and making this day possible. To the friends, family, and loved ones who have supported our graduates, we want to say thank you. We would also like to take this opportunity to recognize the many veterans, active duty military personnel, and military family members with us today. On behalf of the Parker University family, thank you for your service to our country. We invite the veterans in the audience to please stand and be recognized for your service. Parker University officially opened on September 12, 1982, with 27 students in Irving, Texas. The charter class graduated in September 1985. I don't like it when it's dark either. Parker University now offers 34 academic programs and leads the way in patient-centric, collaborative, and conservative healthcare education, clinical practice, research, and service. Today we are participating in the 116th commencement of Parker University. There are 111 DC graduates in this class, making a total of 8,717 Parker Doctor of Chiropractic graduates. Yeah. Parker University is also conferring degrees today to our graduating classes of the Masters of Science in Functional Nutrition, Masters of Science in Neuroscience, Masters of Public Health, and the Masters of Science in Strength and Human Performance programs. Finally, today, We will also award Bachelor of Science degrees with a major in anatomy and a major in health and wellness. And now it is my honor to introduce the rest of the platform party. Dr. William E. Morgan, President of Parker University. Dr. Stephen Brooks, Chairman of the Parker University Board of Trustees. Dr. Tony DeRamis, Alumni Board President and Board of Trustees member. Dr. Christopher Cantu, our commencement keynote speaker. Feel the love. Dr. Tammy Fogarty, Dean of Health and Human Performance. And to my left, your right. Dr. Patrick Bodner, Chief Compliance Officer. Dr. Celia McGuire, Dean of Academics, College of Chiropractic. Dr. Leon Tom, Dean of Clinics, College of Chiropractic. And of course, Ms. Elena Mount, Associate Provost and Dean of Student Affairs. We would like to recognize any members of the Parker University Board of Trustees who may be joining us for our celebration today. Please join me in recognizing this group of leaders and thanking them for their service. I would also like to honor and recognize some additional members of our amazing senior leadership team at Parker University. These senior administrators work alongside myself and our university president to help run the institution and provide an optimal learning environment for our students. Mr. Donnie McNutt, Executive Vice President and Chief Operating Officer. Ms. Sandra McLean, Vice President of Culture Strategy. Dr. Don Dishman, Dean of Clinical Neuroscience. Dr. Tammy Fogarty, Dean of Health and Human Performance. Dr. Drew Reif, Dean of the College of Health Sciences. Ms. Andy Rep, Senior Director and Registrar. Mr. Michael Jackson, Senior Director of Institutional Effectiveness and Planning. Thank you. It is appropriate and vital to recognize a group of dedicated individuals who have given much time and effort to assist these graduates in achieving their goals and help make this day possible. We at Parker University believe we have the finest faculty and staff of any institution in the world. I want the faculty and staff to stand, please, and receive acknowledgement for your efforts. Carrying the ceremonial mace in today's commencement program is our Faculty Senate President, Dr. Sandra Norton, Professor, Department of Clinical Sciences. The honored faculty voted on by the April 2024 class are Dr. Christopher Cantu, Assistant Professor, Department of Chiropractic Sciences, Dr. Jay Ferguson, Associate Professor, Department of Basic Sciences, Dr. Michael Moore, Associate Professor, Department of Clinical Sciences, Dr. Monique Lyons, Clinic Faculty Doctor, Dr. Brad Hartung, Clinic Faculty Doctor, Dr. Kim Jaque, Clinic Faculty Doctor, and hooding today's candidates are Dr. Ronald Wells and Dr. Brad Hartung. And our faculty marshal today is Dr. Jay Ferguson. Thank you all for your assistance in this commencement program. Ladies and gentlemen, we would like to first recognize the candidates for the Master of Functional Nutrition, Masters of Strength and Human Performance, Masters of Public Health, and Masters of Neuroscience programs. Please help me welcome to the podium Dr. Tammy Fogarty, Dean of Health and Human Performance.
Thank you. Hello. On September 3rd, 2019, Parker University launched our Master's of Science program in Functional Nutrition. This challenging, creative, and intensive program is evidence-based and focuses on nutritional biochemistry, its application in health maintenance, treatment of disease, and disease prevention. On May 4th, 2020, we launched the Master's of Science in Strength and Human Performance. This exciting program of study is also evidence-based and focuses on physiology, biomechanics, human metabolism to promote health, enhance physical performance, prevent athletic injuries in pediatrics and adults, and provide strength and conditioning for both collegiate and professional athletes. On January 3rd, 2021, we launched the Masters of Public Health. This much-needed program of study is designed to increase the number of public health practitioners that are prepared to plan, implement, and evaluate programs designed to meet the health needs of a variety of populations. All three of these rigorous programs of study, many of the graduates who sit before you today have completed these degrees while concurrently enrolled full-time in the Doctor of Chiropractic program. Parker is very proud of the graduating class for the Master of Science in Functional Nutrition, our first Master of Science in Public Health, and the Master of Science in Strength and Human Performance degrees.
In early 2019, Parker University launched its popular Master of Neuroscience degree program. This program consists of a very in-depth and broad range of studies in human neuroanatomy, neurophysiology, and the dysfunction of the nervous system. Students in the Master of Neuroscience may also complete an optional clinical residency. It is a very rigorous program, and many of the graduates that sit before us today have completed this program while concurrently enrolled full-time in the Doctor of Chiropractic program. Parker is very proud of the graduating class for the Master of Neuroscience and those that completed the additional clinical residency. Please help me welcome to the podium Parker University's Associate Provost and Dean of Student Affairs, Elena Mount.
Graduation is a day when all students look forward to celebrating with their family and friends and finally getting a chance to walk the stage wearing their regalia. Will the master's degree candidates please stand? Those assisting in the conferring of the degrees, please take your place. I present to you the graduating class of April 2024 for the Master of Functional Nutrition, Master of Neuroscience, Master of Public Health, and Master of Strength and Human Performance programs. The faculty have determined that each of these students have completed or will soon complete all of the degree requirements. Also, the faculty have certified them as worthy of the title and degree. Graduates, please come forward as directed by your faculty marshal, and I will now present our graduates.
Yeah, you can, Dr. Wells will put it on. Graduating with a Master's of Functional Nutrition, Rebecca Jackson. Joe Miranda. Mackenzie Rose Nowak. Graduating with a Master of Strength and Human Performance, Malik Hassan Ali. Ainsley Noel Archer. Selena Danielle Biasi. Zachary Brian Carver. Angel Esteban Davila. Peyton Davis. Jesse Henry Hannes. Kendall Mackenzie Lewis. Sydney Elizabeth Meyer. Becky Rice. Justin Jerome Tolentino. William Eric Trotman. Aubrey Ann Whitehorn. Jessica Marie Zuniga. Graduating with a Master's of Neuroscience, Tanzim Hossein. Miranda McNan. Brittany Priscilla Quiroz Camacho. And Alyssa Lene Smiley. Please join me in congratulating our master's degree graduates. And now to begin the recognition of our Doctor of Chiropractic graduating class. The salutatorian designations are very special recognitions of American higher education. The salutatorian is an academic title given in the United States and Canada to the second highest graduate based on grade point average of the entire graduating class. The rank of second in the class is one of great achievement. Today, Parker University is proud to recognize our salutatorian for the April 2024 graduating class, who has completed this challenging course of study with a 3.80 cumulative GPA. Please join me in congratulating our salutatorian, Paul Eide.
So on a lot of levels, I don't feel worthy to be giving this address, so I'm really humbled to be able to share just a few words with you all. First off, I want to take a moment to thank the people who have contributed above and beyond to allow me to be standing here today. First off, my wife, my entire family, including my in-laws, but especially my parents, who have willfully given up so many of their own hopes, aspirations, and desires for this to be possible. I also want to thank a few people at Parker, Drs. Katie Pullman, Catherine Hartlieb, Marianne Demack, Cody Demack, Brandon Beckerman, and Anthony Angus. I also want to thank you, all of you, my classmates, for all the enriching conversations I've had the opportunity to share with you. You're such inspiring souls with wonderfully rich backgrounds. From Queens, New York, to Costa Rica, from the island of Guam, to the down-home guys and gals from right here in the great state of Texas. Some of you were paramedics before entering Chiro School. You were Olympic athletes. You had thriving business careers. You were and are dedicated members of our country's armed forces. Some of you did multiple of these things before even starting this program. And so, because of all these unique experiences, I had the opportunity and the privilege of learning from each of you things that there's no way I could have possibly learned strictly from the academic side of this education. To all the friends and family of the graduates that are here with us today, if you didn't have a chiropractor in the family already, now you've got someone in the family who will hound you about your posture for the rest of your life. So you have that to look forward to. Thank you for being here today. You truly make this day feel special for each one of us. Lastly, and most importantly, thanks be to God for the graces that he's given us to be able to complete this program. He's given all of us the brilliant minds and the compassionate hearts to be able to learn vast amounts of information and to serve our neighbors and our patients with love. What I've realized at the ripe age of 26 is that I've got no real wisdom to share from my own thoughts or experiences. In fact, any wisdom or advice that I give from the stage today is just coming from a jobless 26-year-old who's about to move in with his in-laws. Please, please don't feel too bad for me, though. I'm actually quite looking forward to it, so. The first piece of wisdom is clinical, and it helps you remember to trust your gut when there are signs that a patient needs to be referred to a medical doctor or to the emergency room. As Dr. Cody Demack, a physiotherapy and advanced rehab professor here, eloquently puts it, if it smells fishy, it's probably a fish. The next piece is about breath. I could go on all day about breath, as my wife will tell you, who's had to listen to me talk about breath nonstop for the last 3 years. But I'll leave you just one simple idea. The most important piece of clinical advice I received is a quote from the late Carl Levitt, a Czech neurologist, who said, if breathing is not normalized, no other movement pattern can be. I hope that one sticks with each of us because I think it's an absolutely critical idea. Lastly, Dr. Marianne Demack, a professor of nutrition, functional assessment, and perinatal rehab, emphasized the importance of finding your why. For a moment, I'd like to hone in on this idea. I think the first order of business after graduating, if you haven't done so already, should be to find your purpose. Then, in clinical practice, find out what other people's whys are, what their purpose is. If they aren't quite sure, help them discover what their why is, because it will change their life for the better. And far more important than cracking backs, correcting subluxations, restoring joint motion, decreasing nociception, improving biomechanics, or whatever the heck you believe we accomplish when we manipulate people's joints, is the importance of empowering people to change their lives for the better. If we can have even a minuscule role in that process, I think we should consider that an absolutely tremendous honor. So, to my fellow classmates, the Parker graduating class of 2024, as we depart from this place, trust your gut, value your breath, and find your why. Congratulations to you all. I'm honored to be graduating alongside you today.
Thank you, Paul, and congratulations again. Now, let me take this opportunity to announce the valedictorian of the April 2024 graduating class. The valedictorian is the academic title given to the graduate with the highest cumulative grade point average. The rank of first in the graduating class represents a significant academic achievement at Parker University, an achievement based on sustained effort over several years. Parker's valedictorian completed this challenging course of study with a 3.86 cumulative GPA. Please join me in congratulating Kendall Lewis.
Welcome, fellow classmates, families, friends, faculty, and esteemed guests. I am incredibly honored to be standing in front of you today as our class's valedictorian. This was an accomplishment that never crossed my mind, as I viewed so many of you as more qualified to accept this award. It did not help that Dean Mount sent me this email congratulating me on April Fool's Day. It is a safe assumption that I frantically checked my email the remainder of the week to see if it was a prank. By the fact that I'm up here on stage now, you can all confirm it was not a mistake, and I'm very grateful to be in front of you today. A special thank you to my people who got me to this point. You know who you are, and I honestly would not be here on the stage without your constant support. I'd like to first start by giving a round of applause to my fellow colleagues. The completion of a Doctorate of Chiropractic program included many long hours to complete skills check, practicals, exams, IMAs, MCOs, and boards. It's an important distinction that you did not just complete this program, but you conquered it. I watched many of you join leadership opportunities, spend your lunches attending open labs or clubs, and use your limited free time attending seminars to enhance your knowledge. Throughout our 3.5-year academic journey, we concurrently experienced some amazing highs and difficult lows. Some of us got married or engaged, had children, made lasting friendship and memories, and found personal growth. Some of us uprooted our families' lives to move to Dallas, missed important events, dealt with health issues, or lost loved ones. I am in awe and true admiration of the fight and determination it took each of you to be here today. You should all feel a sense of pride and accomplishment, and maybe even a little relief as you walk across this stage. I would like next to give a round of applause to the families and friends in attendance today and online. We would not be here today without all your encouragement and support. It takes a village, and I think I can speak for everyone when I say thank you for all that you all do. Personally, I know my mom will miss the 7 phone calls a day, but don't worry, Mom, I think it's just 5 now. Lastly, I would like to give a round of applause to our amazing faculty and staff at Parker University. Our professors spent countless hours supplementing the traditional Parker experience with online material and support through our first few trimesters during COVID limitations. As we transitioned to more classes in person, our professors crafted new material, teaching techniques, and learning opportunities to push us to be more critical thinkers. Our CFDs took on arguably one of the most difficult tasks of transitioning us into patient care. There was lots of laughter, a good amount of tears, and ample amount of personal and professional growth. I'm not usually one for lack of words or thoughts. However, I spent more time than I care to admit to formulate something I felt was worthy of leaving you here today as you transition out of being a student and into the world being a chiropractor. I kept coming back to a commencement speech a high school teacher showed me at the completion of my AP Physics class. It's a speech labeled, "You're Not Special," by David McCall. What starts out as a humbling speech, he describes a moment like this, and I quote, "In your ceremonial costumes, shapeless, uniform, one size fits all. Whether male or female, tall or short, scholar or slacker, spray tan prom queen, or intergalactic Xbox assassin, each of you is dressed, you'll notice, exactly the same. And your diploma, but for your name, exactly the same." I I remember being initially offended, as I'm sure many of you are feeling at this moment, but stay with me. He is not wrong. We are no different than the previous and future chiropractors that have or will walk across this stage. Our newly achieved doctorate degree does not make us special or all-knowing. However, from this point forward, you have the opportunity to become special. Parker University has given us the skills and knowledge to go into the world and create an impact. Maybe you'll become a special within the entire chiropractic community with your new research or groundbreaking approach to care. Or maybe you'll become special to a patient by carefully crafting a patient-centered care approach that helps eliminate their complaint. Or maybe you'll become special among students by coming back to the academic setting and pushing your students to be better. There is no limit to what avenue you choose to leave your impact on. In this moment, I hope you realize we've been prepared with the basics. Our current knowledge is foundational, and we have an unlimited amount of growth associated with it. Today is just the beginning, and each of you has the ability to become special. So congratulations to each and every one of you. Good luck on the beginning of your next chapter. I can't wait to hear what special things you all achieve.
Thank you, Kendall. Next, I would like to welcome the chairman of the Parker University Board of Trustees, Dr. Stephen Brooks, who will present the Robert J. Zopath Service and Leadership Award. Following his presentation, the James W. Parker Philosophy Award, named in honor of our founder, will be presented by our president, Dr. William E. Morgan.
The Robert J. Zopath Service and Leadership Award is presented to a graduating student upon the recommendation of a select committee comprised of faculty, staff, and administrators. The award is in recognition of the dedication and service that reflects the exemplary service and leadership of Dr. Robert J. Zopath, who served as chair of the Board of Trustees of Parker University from 1987 to 2003. Please join me in congratulating Paul Eide.
Each commencement, the James W. Parker Philosophy Award Committee selects a member of the graduating class to be recognized for the exceptional abilities of espousing the philosophy, science, and art of the chiropractic profession. Also, the recipient is recognized for incorporating into their professional philosophy those principles which have become the hallmark of Parker University. Please join me in congratulating Laura Ashton Schwentowski. Laura. I'd like to call up our Executive Vice President and Provost, Dr. Jay Michella.
Thank you, Dr. Morgan. Our commencement speaker, Dr. Christopher Cantu, served 8.5 years in the United States Army, where he found his love for healthcare as a combat medic. After Dr. Cantu was honorably discharged, he attended Parker University, where he learned the art and science of chiropractic from some of the best and brightest professors in the world. Dr. Cantu graduated from Parker University in 2014 as a doctor of chiropractic with a BS in anatomy and a BS in health and wellness. He then went to work as the first chiropractor for Baylor College of Medicine. It was during that time that Dr. Cantu developed his love for physiotherapy techniques by obtaining certifications in cupping, taping, instrument-assisted soft tissue mobilization, and low-level laser therapy, along with his license in equine massage therapy. In 2019, Dr. Cantu returned to his alma mater, Parker University. Dr. Cantu is an associate professor and course director for Physiotherapy 1. In his spare time, Dr. Cantu enjoys spending time with his wife and, I kid you not, 11 children. Please join me in welcoming Dr. Cantu to the podium.
I cannot see anything from up here. Wow. Okay. Thank you, Dr. Michelle, Dr. Morgan, and esteemed board members for allowing me to speak here today. And a special thank you to the parents, family, friends, and of course, Dr. Jay Ferguson, who supported these graduates during their time here at Parker University. Interestingly enough, 10 years ago, this graduation, I walked across this stage, just like you're about to. Today marks a day of celebration, an amazing achievement that every one of you have worked so hard to obtain. And we all know that you've endured many sleepless nights, lots of cram sessions, worried-filled days as you studied for exams and practicals, especially PT1's practicals. Every trial and test have been there to help you hone your skills, to develop you into the professionals that you are today. Now, as you heard, I've not always been a professor, nor have I always been a doctor of chiropractic. I was a combat medic in the United States Army. The best part about being an Army medic is that if you do a good job, you're going to gain the respect of the soldiers that you work for. In 2008, I deployed with the 101st. Before we left, I told my soldiers, I'm going to deploy with you, and I'm going to come home with you. And I'm going to do everything that I can to make sure that that happens. But while I was on deployment, I happened to come up for promotion to E5 Sergeant, which is a difficult feat in itself. I had to pass boards. I imagine you know what that's like. Earned all of my points, or in your case, credits. Passed every assessment. All I had to do now was turn in my packet, and I'll receive my new rank. The night that my packet was due, I went before my PA, my commanding officer, and I asked him. I said, sir, if I submit this packet, will I be able to stay with my platoon? His response was a very clear and precise no. He said, I'd be moved to a new company where I would oversee a group of lower field medics. It was at that time that I had to make a decision. So I told my commanding officer that I respectfully refused to hand my packet in, because I made a promise to those soldiers in my platoon the day we deployed. Needless to say, he was not very happy with me. He locked me up at attention. For those of you who don't know what that is, I could not move. For what felt like an hour, as he berated me, he chastised me, he yelled at me, said it was the stupidest mistake of my career, and that he informed me that I was worthless and useless, that he had no respect for someone like me. He ordered me out of his sight, and that I was not allowed to enter his aid station or speak to him again for the rest of the deployment. Now, that was the nicer version. The actual version had a lot of, language. Word got back to my platoon. They were upset, obviously, that I wasn't going to be able to be receiving my sergeant rank. But they respected the decision that I made to remain with the platoon and the men that I took great pride in taking care of. My first sergeant, who's the highest ranking enlisted member of the company that I was attached to, found out about this. And apparently he made up his own decision to promote me as soon as we got back to the U.S. So I eventually earned my E5 rank. And I was proud to have that rank, but even prouder to have the memories of fighting beside the brave men and women that I swore an oath to protect. I tell you, there's no greater honor than to have the respect of the people for whom you care a great deal about. I tell you this to hopefully inspire you to do just that for your future patients. Before you all move away from here and start the next chapter in your lives, I want to leave you with a single word, a word that the Army taught me that governs and guides my life to this day. Leadership. L-D-R-S-H-I-P. And as you know, I'm not the best at spelling. I'll admit that. But this is an acronym of the values that the Army instills into each and every one of its soldiers. Loyalty, duty, respect, selfless service, honor, integrity, and personal courage. Leadership. Be loyal. Be there for your patients when all other providers have given up on them. Be available no matter how difficult life becomes. And trust me when I tell you this, there will be difficulties ahead of you. Duty. You now have the greatest responsibility to help those in need, an obligation to put the care and well-being of those individuals ahead of your own. Respect. Always treat your patients as people first, regardless of belief, creed, race, or religion. Easiest way to do this is think of that one person who you love the most and ask yourself, would you be happy if they received the same quality care that you're providing? Selfless service. There will come a time when you're going to be tired, hungry, just wanting the day to be over. You're going to have to set that aside and give every patient your unwavering attention as if they're the most important person in your life. Honor. Take pride in your title of doctor. But don't let it go to your head. You're only as important as your patients allow you to be. Integrity. Doing what's right even when nobody is watching. I know, right? He didn't like that one. There will come a time when you'll be tested in practice. You're going to have bills due. Business will be slow. It'll affect you both physically and mentally. But remember that this is just a test. A test to see if you're going to compromise your integrity. Keep focus on helping others. Everything that is needed will be provided. Personal courage. One of the toughest lessons I had to learn as a medic was that I couldn't save everyone. Sometimes the hardest decision were the ones where I had to step aside and allow someone else to take care of my people. You must be willing to accept that you might not be the best person out there for everyone. But you have to have the courage to admit that to yourself and help them find the person who is. And before I wrap this up, I want to leave you with just two more statements. One, you must always be willing to adapt and change. When you stop doing that, you stop growing as a professional and as a person. My personal favorite, always have fun. Because if you're not having fun, why are you doing it? It was with great pleasure that I say to the graduating class of April 2024, congratulations. Thank you for allowing us all to share in this monumentous occasion. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Cantu, for your excellent speech. On behalf of Parker University, I would like to present you this gift to commemorate your contributions to today's ceremony. Thank you.
This is one mic I'm not going to drop.
Please join me in welcoming Parker University's Chief Compliance Officer, Dr. Patrick Bodner.
Parker University is empowered by the accreditation of the Southern Association of Colleges and Schools Commission on Colleges and the State of Texas to award degrees for the following programs: Doctor of Chiropractic, Master of Science in Functional Nutrition, Master of Science in Neuroscience, Master of Science in Strength and Human Performance, Master of Public Health, Bachelor of Science degree with a major in Anatomy, and a Bachelor of Science degree with a major in Health and Wellness. On this special day, we recognize those students who have earned their Bachelor of Science degree while concurrently working towards their Doctor of Chiropractic degree. Will the students graduating with these degrees that I've just mentioned please stand and be recognized? So congratulations. And at this time, I am very pleased to ask Dean Elena Mount to present our candidates for the Doctor of Chiropractic program.
All right, for the moment you've been waiting for, graduates, please stand. Those that are assisting in the conferring of the degrees, please take your places. I present to you the graduating class of April 2024. The faculty have determined that each of these students have completed or will soon complete all of the degree requirements. Also, the faculty have certified them as worthy of the title and degree Doctor of Chiropractic with all of the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. The first set of graduates may come forward. The rest of the graduates, please remain seated until your marshal directs you to rise. Some of our candidates have family members who are doctors in one of the disciplines of the healing arts. It is a tradition at Parker to allow these doctors to participate in this special occasion with the privilege of handing the graduating family member their diploma at the commencement ceremony. Additionally, we have graduates that will be receiving honors today. Those graduates are awarded as the following: cum laude with praise, GPAs 3.5 to 3.74 indicated with a blue cord; magna cum laude with great honor, GPAs 3.75 to 3.89 will be indicated with a silver cord; and summa cum laude with highest praise, GPAs 3.9 to 4.0 will be indicated with a gold cord. And finally, we recognize and honor the service to our country by our veteran graduates. They will be identified by a red, white, and blue cord. I will now present our Doctor of Chiropractic graduates. Jacob Acord. Veronica Fouché Alexander. Malik Hassan Ali. Juan Antonio Alonso Barcena. Ashley Nicole Anderson. Andrade. You said Andrade?
Andrade, yes.
Jordan Andrade. Ainsley Noel Archer, presented by her father, Dr. Joseph Archer. Joshua Avery. Natalie Badon. Sarah Basinger. Kylie Nawan Bates.
You want more again?
Yes.
Sydney Morgan Beaupre. Graduating cum laude, Matthew Raymond Bell. Stephanie Michelle Benjamin. Ryan William Benning. Selena Danielle Biasi. Michael Dante Blakemore. Joshua Cole Blaylock. Bailey Allen Bloodworth. Gabrielle Simone Bowie. Courtney Catherine Bramhall. Allie Broadway. Dejanay Nichelle Burke.
Is it Burrell?
Lauren Nicole Burrell. Zachary Brian Carver. Brittany L. Carey. Kaylin Elise Chambers. Jaden Gray Champagne. Emiliano Cuba Chapa. Connor Jacob Collins. Jacob Allen Corner. Marley Daniel. Anthony Sean Darjean. Angel Esteban Davila. Ashley Ann Davis. Kay Davis. Peyton Davis. Leah Dawson. Adam Michael DeWitt. Graduating magna cum laude, Paul Christian Idy. Evelise Escribano. Justina Fahim. Elliot Hansen Fleming.
Porsche.
Yes, ma'am.
Antonio Marcos Forche.
Andres?
Yes.
Pablo Andres Gomez.
Pablo Andres Gomez. Roy Gomez. Robert Jacob Gonzalez. Morgan Lamar Gorey. Tara Christine Grimes. Jason R. Gooch. Jared Heath. Megumi Homa, presented by her father, Dr. Yoshio Homa. Jesse Henry Hannes, graduating cum laude, presented by his father, Dr. Clifford Hannes. Zachary Ryan Hudson. Rebecca Jackson. Dayan Joe.
DJ, a million.
DJ, a million Johnson Jr. John Wayne Yokepa Johnson. Graduating cum laude, Sadie Landwehr. Samuel Scott Larkin, graduating cum laude, presented by his father, Dr. Scott Larkin. Graduating magna cum laude, Kendall McKenzie Lewis. Cakely Ann Linder. Brandon M. Longden. Raina Yaneth Lopez Silva, presented by her husband, Dr. Cesar Silva. Isaiah Leo Martin. Brittany Nicole Mays. Sydney Elizabeth Meyer. Taylor Miracle. Xavier Moffitt. Brody Lee Morris. Catherine Murtaugh. Jesse Graham Nichols, presented by his mother, Dr. Keela Nichols.
Shame.
Shane Noel. Right? Graduating cum laude, Mackenzie Rose Nowak. Khadija Sade Oliver. Jared Olson. Cruz Rolando Orona. Mackenzie Blair Owens. Jonathan Ozornea. Osvaldo Saul Palacios. Kirsten K. Payne, graduating magna cum laude. Samantha Pierce.
Jericho Pineda.
Yep. Probably not. Cameron Jericho Pineda.
Edlin Ponce Munoz.
Priscilla Edlin Ponce Munoz. Marissa Dawn Quevedo, presented by her father, Dr. Enrique Mario Quevedo II. Brittany Priscilla Quiros Camacho, graduating cum laude and presented by her aunt, Dr. Yolanda Camacho Cortman. Tyler James Rendell. Justin Reyna. Graduating cum laude, Becky Rice. Monique J. Roberts. Ryan G. Ronces. Jada Marnay Saucer. Madeline Diane Sieber. Alyssa Lene Smiley.
Brian St. John.
Brian St. John. Graduating magna cum laude, Laura Ashton Swintoski. Krisha Abby Thomas. Justin Jerome M. Tolentino, presented by his sister, Dr. Ashley Tolentino Garcia. Daniela Valdez. Alberto Antonio Valenzuela. Loanne Van. Michael Van. Trey Votrot. Haley Vinson. Tan Vo.
Tavares.
Courtney Tavares Williams.
Elisha.
Elisha. Mm-hmm. John Elisha Wilson. And graduating cum laude, Jessica Marie Zuniga. Please join me in congratulating our April 2024 Doctor of Chiropractic graduating class. Congratulations, graduates. Please help me welcome back to the podium Chief Compliance Officer of Parker University, Dr. Patrick Bodner.
All right. So, Doctor of Chiropractic graduates, please stand and raise your right hand and repeat after me for the chiropractic oath. Additionally, we would like all the doctors of chiropractic in the audience to please stand and join us in reaffirming their commitment by reciting the oath with the graduates. So graduates, please recite after me. I do hereby affirm before God and these assembled witnesses that I will keep this oath and life commitment to hold in esteem and respect those who taught me this chiropractic healing art. To follow the methods of treatment which according to my ability and judgment, I consider for the highest benefit of my patients. To abstain from whatever is deleterious and unethical. And to stand ready at all times to serve my fellow man. Without distinction of race, creed, or color. With purity, I will pass my life and practice my art. I will at all times consider the patients under my care to be of supreme importance. I will not spare myself in providing my patients the care. I have been taught to give by my alma mater. I will keep inviolate all things revealed to me as a physician. While I continue to faithfully keep this oath, may it be granted to me to enjoy life and the practice of the chiropractic healing art. Respected by all people at all times. Okay. Congratulations. All right, you may be seated. And please welcome back to the podium our president, Dr. William Morgan.
Thank you, Dr. Bodner. Thank you to the graduates and all of our guests, and this is a very important part of the ceremony was the oath, and I'd like to talk a little bit about that. But first I'm going to talk about the coin that everyone was given as they crossed the stage. It's kind of a talisman that we give every one of our graduates, something to keep with you and to hold on to and to refer to. And in fact, last night we had an event with many of our alumni there, and one started tapping their coin on the counter, you know, signaling to everybody else to bring their coin out. And those who didn't have a coin were the ones picking up the tab. So when you're at some place where there's libations, make sure you have that coin with you at a Parker event. And the history of the coin goes back 2,000 years originally, where in Caesar's army, they would give ceremonial coins for valor and courage. And it was reintroduced during Vietnam with the Army Special Forces, where they made unit coins so they could remember those who had gone through training with, those who had passed, and the experiences they had gone through together. So as a memorial to your classmates, carry this with you and refer to our first technique. Loving service is our first technique. That's why you probably came to Parker, to be a loving servant, to go out and help hurt humanity in a world that has a system of disease care that needs your healing hands. Now, chiropractic, for those who aren't familiar with it, is a unique healing art. Our goal is to remove the barrier to good health and let the body heal itself. That's what all of our majors are based upon, be it chiropractic or neurology or nutrition or all these. This is how we choose our majors, to go out into the world and help people to realize maximized health and high human performance. The oath was important. It's important that you're here. See, everybody in attendance is part of the ceremony because you're the witnesses to that oath. The oath for healing arts goes back to Hippocrates. Before Hippocrates had that oath, the Hippocratic Oath, physicians could take advantage of slaves or females or share secrets or maybe take a bribe to give something that would cause harm than healing. But when Hippocrates had that oath, it was not 100 years before everyone in the ancient world required their physician to have high moral standards. Are you a physician of the oath? And if they weren't, they wouldn't go to them. So you are here to hold these graduates responsible for that oath throughout their whole life. You're the family, friends, loved ones that you're here as witnesses to that oath. They said that oath. You are part of this whole ancient ceremony as we wear this ancient garb to hold them up to that oath. And oaths are very important. And that's my favorite part of the ceremony. I think it's going to be your favorite part, too. Graduates, please stand. Upon the recommendation of the faculty, and by the authority vested in me as President of Parker University by the Board of Trustees and the great state of Texas, I hereby confer upon you the degrees of Doctor of Chiropractic, Master of Science, Master of Public Health, and Bachelor of Science with all rights, privileges, and responsibilities thereto pertaining. You may now move your tassel from the right side to the left. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in congratulating our newest graduates, and let me be the first to call you doctors. Welcome to the profession, doctors.
You may be seated. Don't worry, we're almost halfway. Okay. So honored guests, family, and friends, we kindly ask that you allow the graduates to process out of the chamber first and then proceed to meet your graduate at the reception located in the lobby. We are so glad that you were able to spend time with us today. Please join me in prayer at this time. Almighty God, thank you for this wonderful day and the time we have all spent together at this graduation ceremony. Let us leave one another thankful for the many blessings you have bestowed upon us. Bless the Parker University faculty, staff, and students so they live with faith and purpose. Please guide people so we have tolerance for each other, are kind to each other, and live in such a way that when we make our last walk on this earth, you will take us by the hand and say, welcome home. Amen. And that's it, folks.